Reviews here. Today we're taking a look at the TWS1 earbuds. So I just recently got these and let's have a look inside the box here. Got the case here. These are the wireless earbuds themselves. You can see it's a glossy finish here this time around as opposed to the older TWS2s, which are a matte finish and have a nice set of indicators here, as you can see, for the whites, white LEDs there. This time it is an embossed finish here on the top, glossy case, which I don't like so much because it gets scratched up easier. There's still micro USB charging. It's not a big deal because it's got a long battery life, this one. Claimed 8 hours on a single charge when it's out of the box, and then an extra 24 from the case. I suppose to not mention it's a little bit shorter than the TWS2. Depth and height are almost the same there. So returning to the box, we also have micro USB charging cable, set of tips, small, medium and large, quick instruction manual, and there's a certificate of conformity here, or declaration of testing. I'm not sure which one it is because I can't read Chinese, but it definitely looks like one of them. Going to the back of the box, we can see the specs themselves. So this time we are dealing with a sensitivity of 98 decibels this time, as opposed to the 94 in the TWS2. 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz there for the frequency response range. Pretty much the same as the TWS2. Not sure about the impedance because that wasn't stated here. So it reckons it's got some voice cancellation technology. Haven't tried that out for phone calls yet, but I imagine it'll work pretty much the same. So it is, this time around, Qualcomm aptX is the audio codec for Bluetooth, which is purported to improve the streaming audio quality over the SBC in the older TWS2 here. It's SBC only. Connects via that for default. And the aptX on this one, because it pops up in the Bluetooth settings on my Xiaomi phone. As you can see, Bluetooth 5.0, 8 hours on a single charge. It's using the newer Qualcomm 3026 chipset. IPX5 water and dust resistance, up from IPX4 on the TWS2. So that's it for the box there. Going back to the earphones themselves, as you can see, we have the, don't know if you can see it on there we go, red LEDs to indicate that they are charging there. It's a bit hard to see because of the glossy finish this time around. This isn't the global version, so voice prompts to say it's connecting and all of that sound through the earbuds themselves, they will be in Chinese. It's not a big deal, it's pretty obvious to that they're connecting and all of that. And it will show up in your phone anyway as a little system message to say that it's connected and how much battery is remaining. These do have touch controls this time around, so it's no longer a push-in button like the TWS2 were. I personally don't like touch controls. I know some people like them, but they tend to me to have a lot of misfires and accidental registration of touches and so forth. But they do the usual functions. So double tap on the left to go previous track, double tap on the right to go the next track, single tap to play and pause. You can see a triple tap or hold down to access your default voice assistant on your phone, like Siri or Google Assistant. I do find the magnetic clasp mechanism to be more secure than TWS2. These are a little bit flimsy, kind of don't go all the way in at times. Coming to the sound quality themselves, they are pretty decent. The bass level is about the same as the TWS2. Sensitivity is a bit lower, as you can see on the 98, as compared to the 94 on the TWS2. But they're pretty good, pretty decent there, and they do work very well. The highs aren't too high; they're not clipped or distorted. So the sibilance, so songs where they say a lot of like the S sound in words, and the cymbals on drums, they're not clipped or sound distorted or too high or piercing. The bass isn't muddy or anything; it's pretty strong, but it isn't muddy. So they are almost a perfect match for the sound on the TWS2. Coming to the battery life. We have a claimed 8 hours on a single charge, so that's a single charge when it comes out, and it's not returned to the case because this is utilizing Qualcomm's chipset that they announced last year, the 30QCC3026. And in my testing, I've gotten from 7 to 7.5 hours on each charge, so that is pretty good. That's up from the 2.5 to 3 hours on the TWS2. So I know different manufacturers are banging on about, you know, having 60 hours total charge, or 120 or 80 or 50 or 40. It doesn't really matter on these because they're the newer chipset. This will last you a long time. I don't know, I'd say probably nearly a week of heavy usage. So yeah, that's almost it for this video. I believe these are the TWS ones. Sorry, I believe they are the EarJoy ones that were announced at CES 2019. TWS5 is already announced, and they have a high sensitivity of, I think it's 102 decibels. It's not quite up my alley, because to me it sounds like they do get louder, but there's more potential for clipping. I've always had better experiences with lower sensitivity ones anyway. So yeah, I don't like the case so much, and the LED, going back to LEDs, just the single red one here just makes it look cheap, really, just cheaped out on the case here. I really prefer the matte case of the TWS2. Did look a lot better here. This does get scratched up a bit, TWS2, so you can see there are scratches there, but it's got to be nowhere near as much on this matte finish as opposed to the newer TWS1, which has this cheaper glossy finish. As you can see, it's a fingerprint magnet, sorry, and this would just get scratched to hell in my backpack. But I think because they're maybe 16 ohms impedance, they haven't stated on their website or anything. Voices do sound a little bit more distant than they do on the TWS2, but with a good fit, with the right size earbuds, yeah, the difference is almost negligible. And the fit is a little bit not so good, because it seems to be similar plastic, but it feels a little bit not so good. As you could hear there, connecting in Chinese and all of that. I'd still highly recommend these ones. Pretty good value for the money. You get them on Joy Buy and Banggood, I believe, at the moment. Would I get these over the TWS5? I'd say so. There's not much difference in the two, really. Yeah, so I'm not quite sure why they put both of them out. Maybe it's for different markets to get higher sales or whatnot. Anyway, that's going to do it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I hope that this helped inform your purchasing decision of this particular set of wireless earbuds. Okay, thank you and have a good night. Goodbye.